What's going on, YouTube? It's the Bushy Beard, and I'm back, and I'm bushier than ever. And right now, we're just getting started on videos. I thought, you know, I would wait for my mom because she got home from work, and she said we can do it a little bit later, and a little bit later turned into 8 o'clock, and so here we are doing videos finally.
Blame it on the mom.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But, yeah, so.
But it's true.
Yeah. So we, and trust me, I would not be able to do a video without her because you guys would jump on me, so.
I don't know that that's true.
Here we go. We got Run Direction's complete Xfactor story, part 6. Here we go. Just as a heads up, I will be skipping some of it that is like the intro to the show and stuff like that, where it's not just about One Direction, to try to save some time.
Cause it's, we just want One Direction.
Minutes, yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Is it, I was about to say, is there?
Welcome to the Xfactor Mega Mind. I'm your host, Louis Tomlinson, and we've got some questions from our Talk customers. Today, head to head, we have Matt Cardle and Aiden Grimshaw. So first up is Matt Cardle.
Yeah, well, don't know them.
Well, I think he's the one that ended up winning.
Oh, okay.
But, yeah, so, I mean, I guess I'll watch it just because Louie's in it, okay. But it's not necessarily about Louie.
Okay,
so.
Matthew, your question starting 4, 3, now. Darren Andrews, what do you think about the media coverage surrounding you?
Some of it is lies.
Susie Murray says, what was the best performance this week?
One Direction.
David Jackson says, are you happy with your song choices so far?
So far, yes. Maybe not this week.
Ooh, Kirsty Brownie says, what's your favourite song to perform in front of a live audience and why?
Alanis Morissette, thank you. Because it's amazing.
Ben Fidget says,
right,
what made you want to be
this.
A singer?
I don't know.
I'm going to have to push you for an answer.
Sorry, y'all. It's just once we really don't care about the other people as much.
Yeah,
like, we got Louis. We know his character,
gonna,
so.
Yeah, we're going to move on.
Akana! So join us next week for more mega fun on Mega Mind.
Hi, we're One Direction. And this is Pop, Flop, or Fizzle.
Flop or fizzle.
So first we've got Pixie Lott, Broken Arrow. We had a little synth. Has pushed you away and you can't. Kind of a Kelly Clarkson kind of sound.
Yeah, I like it.
Very, and she's really hot.
Yes.
The next song we have is Joe McElroy's new single. Ambitions. You're breaking
it to separate parts. So I feel like this is a phone commercial or like spot because it's on a phone.
Okay.
And they're
I was
showing
trying to figure
phone.
Out what was going on.
Yeah, but I mean, I guess it's new people's or music from new artists and stuff
on
like that.
On YouTube or something? Or?
No.
No, just
established artists probably.
Oh.
Welcome to the first edition of the Xfactor Mr. and Mrs. This week we'll be finding out just how well Simon's remaining acts really do know each other. Armed with questions from our Talk customers,
this will be interesting.
We pitted Bellamy and One Direction in a head-to-head battle. The rules are simple. We asked each act the same set of questions to see how they thought the other would respond. Here's how they got on.
What would the ultimate theme for an X-Men? Okay.
What would Bellamy's ultimate theme be? About moaning.
Moaning, yeah. In all seriousness, it could actually be moaning. A moaning week.
Moaning?
Week.
Our answer is Soul Sister Week.
Soul Sister?
If One Direction we're going to choose a theme, it would probably be the thong theme.
Let me see that thong.
Have you heard that song before?
Mm-mm.
It's an old 90s song by, I think it's, I don't remember who it's by, actually. It might be Nelly.
Let me get you a little better, Harry. Oh, I call them thong, 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 thong.
wrong.
Theme or
yeah.
something.
Yeah.
Or chingy? I don't know.
Swimwear yeah, theme. Yeah. Swimwear theme.
Probably naked women theme.
Who's their favorite to win the X Factor?
They already said it was that.
I think I mean, Bellamy yeah. would probably want.
I reckon they'd want.
Tracy to win. Besides themselves.
Cher.
No, they'd probably want us
oh,
to win.
Cher. 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 No, I reckon they'd want Rebecca Ferguson to win. Either Matt or Rebecca Ferguson.
Our favorite to win the X Factor, apart from us, is Matt.
They got along
right.
Yeah, Matt and Abe maybe.
Matt and Abe probably. I think we would like to see Matt win the X Factor this year.
Who would they say is the smelliest in the contestants' house? Interesting.
I reckon Bellamy would probably be
Course.
One of us.
Oh,
They would say that. I know they would. How much do you actually want to bet right now?
I'll bet you. 54 pence.
I
don't know what a pence is.
56
a pence is like a penny.
Oh,
I don't.
Okay. We think that Bellamy would either say one of us or Wagner.
We think that One Direction are the smelliest.
Oh, they were right.
Louis was right.
Or Zane was.
Have you seen our room? We can't even get in it. Get a bin bag and empty the rubbish.
He says it won't work. It won't work. It'll be like
no one'll do it. Yeah, they're probably dead themselves.
So do we think?
Oh, we already know.
Just themselves. Probably.
Yeah. We think the
smelliest person in the house.
Smelliest person house is Sophia.
Sophia is.
And by that we mean like perfume, right, guys?
Yeah.
Smelliest with perfume.
Sure.
Only smelliest in a nice way.
Yeah, that's it.
Talk, X Factor Q&A. On my panel today with me, I have Niall Horan,
well, hi,
John Adelaide, Sophia Wadman.
Oh, that's Sophia. Okay.
Wagner and Lou Thomas.
Hello.
Now, over to the first question from the lady with the paper hat.
So, this question's from Rebecca Pierce, Northern Ireland. What is your hidden talent other than singing?
What is your hidden talent other than reacting?
Yeah, like that's a talent. I would say my hidden talent is something that I use at my job is empathy.
Okay. Mine would be magic.
You know, I'm not sure, but details. I think okay. I think you're
detail oriented.
And I'm very surprised you didn't say winning arguments.
That I mean, that's not super secret.
Oh, that's
or hidden.
True.
That's out there.
Yes, it is.
Duh.
Yeah.
Other than singing, what is your hidden talent?
I can draw. She's well good. I used to draw a lot. Actually,
alright. Very nice. Wagner, what is your hidden talent?
I can draw. I can draw cartoons of people's faces.
Cartoons.
I dedicated my life to karate.
I can see that.
Hiya, Chris.
You know, there are those cartoon sketchers uh-huh. at like amusement parks and stuff.
Yeah.
I can see him doing that.
Yeah.
Next question.
Too much testosterone running through their bodies.
That's not testosterone right there. That's just plain boyhoodness.
This one's from Mark Cutler in Bournemouth. Do you wear something lucky when you sing on the live shows?
Do you have a lucky charm?
No.
Yeah, neither do I.
Personally, I wear green underpants. Now, Knight, what do you wear when you're singing this lucky?
I wear white socks.
White socks. Nice.
That's just a common thing people wear.
You know, back in my day,
yeah,
high school, anybody that wore white socks were called greasers.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
oh.
I don't know. I don't know why, but I guess the cool thing was to wear
colored socks.
Socks. Yeah.
Probably black shoes, but nice.
Yes.
Lovely. What do you wear that's lucky?
I have a lucky nose ring.
Yeah. I have never seen him wear that.
Yeah, I don't know. Doesn't one of the boys have a nose ring? I want to say it's Zane. Maybe later in it. I'm not 100% sure. I don't remember.
Me neither.
Let us know down in the comments if any of them have a nose ring.
What do you wear in this room?
My father's unique and handmade lucky charm.
Aww. That's an actual lucky thing.
Yeah.
That all the other ones have been probably jokes.
Yes. My own unique and handmade. And the cross. The most powerful weapon.
Wagner wears a hell of a lot of handmade lucky stuff. Next question, please.
He cut him off when he was about to say the most powerful.
Yeah.
Dang it.
This one's from Sarah Goodwin in Chippenham. If you were a chocolate bar, what would you be and why?
Very nutty.
So
just called nutrageous. Very nutty. Oh, outrageous.
Nutrageous.
Nutrageous.
I think is an actual
for
candy
you.
Bar. No, for you.
Oh, I thought we were making them up.
No.
Oh.
I think they mean established candy bar.
If there's a nutrageous, or what's payday?
Payday? Okay.
That's really that's a lot of nuts.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. For me, I would say, I don't really know.
We would have to call him Snickers.
Why?
Well, because
I have many layers.
No, because we snicker at you all the time.
Because I'm so likable that everybody likes me. The most universally well-loved candy bar. I think you're right. I am a Snickers because I'm universally loved.
That's a Snicker.
What type of bar would you be?
I'd probably be a flake.
Why? Are you flaky?
Quite flaky, yeah.
Flake. Oh.
Flake.
I'd be Terry's chocolate orange.
Of course.
It's mine. It's not Terry's. It's mine. Go away, Terry.
Rob, it smells like orange. That was the X Factor question time. Thanks for joining us. Join us next week. Goodbye.
Tonks for joining us. Tonks.
Bye, Ed. See you later, Ed.
Probably in primary school.
I think Wagner is over them.
Yeah, he's like, whatever.
Yeah.
They're all over in a primary school play. Lisa, can I have some more?
Lead up to the third live show.
What we're One Direction, and this is our video diary week 3.
Last week we had a really good time, but it wasn't without upset. Harry got ill halfway through the week. It was just a bit of a shock, and our rehearsal went really, really bad. So we've all been kind of nervous this week.
I think he's got a temperature now.
Luckily, on the night, we all pulled it off. It was the best performance I think so far that we've done in the competition.
I think the audience were amazing. Mm. It was they were really, really behind us.
It was really loud. Really loud.
Great
really
atmosphere. Loud.
And then everybody voted for us and we're so happy.
Thank you so much for voting. Don't
please.
Stop.
Our song this week, we can't reveal. It's under this hat. Just give you a sneak peek. I'm a song!
I think they don't get a whole lot of sleep, and I think that's what's showing through is like their tiredness, maybe, because this is very,
ridiculous.
Yeah, it's a very tired feeling,
like,
guys.
Look at Harry right there.
This is great, though. It's fun.
This week's song is going to be lots of fun and a little bit different to what we've done the past 2 weeks. So we're going to really enjoy it, and we hope everyone at home likes it.
Guess what I am?
This is question time now, and we had a question from Sumina, and her question was, who would we most like to date in the house?
Contestant.
I'm going to kick it off, and I'm going to say Cher.
Okay.
I'm going to say Tracy.
I'm going to say Rebecca Ferguson.
Go on.
He's not going to say something real here.
He's going to say Harry.
Yeah, something like that, just because that's him.
I don't want to say mine yet.
Mine would probably be Mary.
I knew he wasn't going to say it either. Because Mary's the old lady.
Oh, now who did Louis say?
We don't know yet. Probably he was going to say Mary. But
I thought he said something.
He said, I'm not ready to tell mine yet.
It's mine.
Yeah, we had that thing going on, remember?
See? She's mine!
We also had a question from Charlotte, and she wanted to know if any of us could play any musical instruments. I'm quite handy with a kazoo, but that's fine.
Oh yeah, I can play a piano. A little bit.
A little bit of guitar and a little bit of piano.
I can play the guitar.
And I can play the triangle.
I can play the triangle.
I can play the cowbell.
Yeah. We had a question from Elise, which was, how are we finding the attention?
How are we finding it, Lee?
How are we finding it? I mean, every morning we'll get up and we'll leave the house, and at the bottom of the road will be packs following us, which is quite random.
We all love the attention from all the girls. Unfortunately, we're not allowed to come and see the girls anymore because, like, there's too many of them out there and it just creates, like, a big fuss. So, we're not being ignorant. We want to come out and see you and we'll appreciate it because, obviously, we love the fact that you support us and vote for us every week.
We wouldn't be here without you guys,
yeah,
either.
Obviously, but, yeah, we just want to say that we love all the attention from you guys.
Oh, and before I forget, there are a few shout-outs that I need to make.
Right in the middle of this?
Yeah, otherwise I'll forget, Mother.
No, just get to the end of it to do
We have... I think this is one. Truly_DIA.deeply. She has continued to show support by posting my videos to her story on Instagram so people can see me.
Uh-huh.
And then... YOUSRA.FARHAN. I thank you for giving me the list of everything that the boys had a hand in writing. So
yeah.
I didn't want to forget those, so thank
Shout
you.
Shout out.
Please continue to support.
It's always nice to see the familiar faces as well.
Yeah.
Gemma.
Lauren, her name.
Lauren Drake, 25. She camped out the other day.
What was that other girl?
Really Victoria Beckham.
And Sophie.
Big Victoria Beckham.
To
Rima.
Rima for drawing the photos of
They're
Harry
amazing.
And Liam. And
they were
yeah.
absolutely brilliant.
Really, really,
really,
really
very good.
Let me just say thanks for that.
We're One Direction. I'm Harry.
I'm Louie.
I'm Niall.
I'm Dane.
And I'm Liam. Thank you for watching our diary, and hopefully we'll see you next week.
Oh, it's on.
Hello. My name is Desavan Kotesha.
The video diaries are pretty funny to watch, though. I'm glad that they included them in here.
Songwriter for Britney Spears, Usher, Alexandra Burke, and so on. Today we are going to learn how to sing with One Direction.
One Direction!
Interesting. The Enrique Creek.
So today we're going to be singing the song Nobody Knows with One Direction. We're going to work on starting a song with the right kind of emotion and a trick that you could use to do that. So, Liam sings the first verse, and we'll have him give it a shot.
I wonder if this is the one that they are singing for the live show.
Nobody knows. Nobody knows but me. I sometimes cry. If I could pretend that I'm asleep when my tears start to fall, I peek out from behind these walls. I think nobody knows.
Oh, that's hilarious. That is funny. They are so silly.
How can you keep a straight face knowing that's all going on?
I know, I would not be able to.
But one trick, Liam obviously sings that wonderfully. One trick you can do in the beginning of a song is what I like to call the Enrique Creek, named after my good friend, Enrique. And that is when you're going to go into the first word of a song, of a ballad like this, is to creak into it, meaning like, instead of going, nobody knows, to go, nobody knows, to have that little nobody knows. And you'll see the difference. It's a lot more intimate and it sort of sucks the audience in a little more.
I wonder if that's an actual, like,
I guess lesson. He is a coach of some kind.
I mean, it makes sense to me, like, just having that, because it has, like, a little...
Because they're listening to him instead of playing around.
Nobody knows. Nobody knows but me. I sometimes try.
They're doing it again.
If I could pretend that I'm asleep when my tears start to fall, I creep out from behind these walls. I think nobody knows. Nobody knows.
So hopefully you hear the difference.
The second time.
Huh?
It was better
than that. No, I agree, yeah.
It's a little tiny detail, but it does help a lot. It helps you get into the song. So how did that feel for you?
I think it's a good trick to use, and it helps you reach the notes just that little bit better and put more emotion in, so it's good.
So thanks, guys. Hopefully that's a useful tip. And there'll be more singing lessons to come.
I could see why people fell in love with them, though. Yeah. I mean, they're just goofy little kids just enjoying life, you know?
Yeah.
And trying to figure out how to deal with fame and notoriety, you know?
Oh, gosh.
I'm sure it's hard for people to kind of, like, figure out and make their way through.
And I liked Liam when he said, hopefully, we'll see you next week. Because I don't really like the swagger, the overconfidence, like, we got this.
Yeah.
So I liked that part of it.
Yeah, me too.
I think Cher Lloyd is amazing.
I confess that I started a party with Cher last night.
Last night at the house, some of the youngsters, which is easy because everybody's younger than me, decided to have a party.
It's guilty pleasure week. There's nothing better than mowing a good lawn.
We're just on our way down to car.
You know, there is that feeling after you're done with the lawn, you look at it and you're like,
well, I mean,
that.
Whenever you do a good job at whatever it is, you look at it and think, I did that.
Yep. Choreography now. There's usually loads of fans there waiting, there's loads of paps.
I'm waiting up at 6 o'clock to come and see One Direction. Yeah.
It's a bit weird for all of us. Just like a couple of months back, we were all at school studying, and now we pull up and there's hundreds of girls outside the fence, like, screaming.
One Direction!
Doing a bit of signing. It was amazing.
Do you know this song?
La Bamba or something.
No, Living the Vida Loca.
Oh, yeah.
She will wear you out. Living the Vida Loca. You know who sings it?
Ricky Martin?
Yep. Black Cats and Superstitions.
You didn't think I was going to know that.
I did not.
We should have had that.
I gotta react to this song on my channel. This is such a classic.
Everyone's going really well. We've had a quick song change during the week. This is our new vocal coach.
We switched songs 2 days ago, but they are good. They're very
good. Oh, they switched at the last minute. Interesting.
2 days ago.
We're building up that drama, you know? We gotta. Are they gonna pull it off? Are they not?
The singer. That song changed twice in the week.
It happened late on in the week, so we didn't have too much time to rehearse.
I try to find the balance between.
Wait, did
solo
he say somebody's voice changed in the middle of the week?
I don't know. Let me see.
Days ago, but they are good. They are very.
Okay, this is our new vocal coach.
We switched songs 2 days ago, but they are good. They are very good singer.
That song changed twice in the week.
Just 2 days ago, but they are good. They are very good singer.
That song changed twice in the week.
Oh, twice. Had the song changed twice.
Day on in the week, so we didn't have too much time to rehearse.
I try to find the balance between being a solo and it gets a little bit soloist moment somewhere in here. Bam, bam, bam.
The voiceover man from the
end. That's right, yes I am.
Hello, hello, hello.
I'm sorry, y'all. I just love that song.
Well, I mean, as long as One Direction's not singing,
Oh, okay.
You can go ahead and sing over the other people.
Okay. Oh, how are you? I'm very good. Very good to see you.
It's time
to face
the music.
Yes, he's right.
One Direction getting screamed at and screaming in my head.
I wonder how that is for everybody else, like how big of a following they've gotten off of the show, while maybe not everybody else has had that following.
Yeah, I'm just glad they don't have Howie Mandel's.
Oh, I know.
I mean, germaphobes. Don't touch me stuff, because, you know, I mean, I guess you couldn't be in this industry.
Yeah.
Hello, I live in the dark space. Come on, baby. Living love you,
darling. We've got a great theme this week. It's guilty pleasures.
Guilt.
We've got a few surprises that are not your normal X Factor type of songs.
It's very upbeat, very childlike, and very guilty.
Yeah.
Okay, so this isn't like the ballad.
No.
I thought it was going to be a ballad. Okay. 2 days before my birthday, it's a sign, Mom.
Of what?
And Simon and the groups fell out.
Big trouble.
After this week, he could be down to one.
What were you going to say?
I want to spit at Simon every time they show his face.
Yeah, after the stuff you've heard. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I get it. But, you know, this is what I think.
And I didn't have that feeling before we started this journey.
This is what I'm going to say, and it's probably going to be semi-controversial.
Oh, no.
But you get into the music business with the understanding, and I get that they're young. And I understand that, and they might have been taken advantage of, but probably had to have their parents sign off on the contracts because they were under 18. I don't know how it works in the UK, but here in America, that's what happens. So you understand what you're signing up for, and you got to understand it's a business. Mm-hmm. Also, you have to understand, if it wasn't for the X Factor and Simon having help put them together, we would never have had One Direction. So it's a catch-22.
And they would never have the anxieties and stuff that they have today.
I understand that. And, you know, I think not all of that is to say it's Simon's fault. Because,
you know, we love them, but they could have been just as happy without it.
Yeah, but this is what I'm going to also say is, like, you hear it from every single artist.
Yes.
That they have anxieties, they have these eating disorders a lot of the time. And it's not just from them, it's the industry and the expectations
stress
placed on them by the fame and things like that. So does Simon have some guilt in it? Probably. Is he the only one to blame for it? I'm going to say no. I mean, it's probably going to be
a
controversial opinion.
I'm glad you're going to be the one on the block this week.
I always am. But that's where I'm coming from. It's like, I understand both sides.
I know, I agree.
And they left with $50 million. They never have to work again.
Here's the thing also. In politics, it's the same way.
Yeah.
You're under stress. You have mentors.
Mm-hmm.
I sort of agree with you.
I mean, I'm not saying Simon is a good person. I don't know him personally. I only know what people say of him.
Mm-hmm.
And I get that he's probably not the best guy, but he's in a business to make money. It's just like everybody else.
Yeah.
So that's the only thing I'm going to say about it. I wish they were treated better.
Sort of like a band director.
Yeah.
If anybody's been in a band, which I didn't know because I was never in a band, but when my kids were in the band, those band directors are like little drill sergeants.
Yeah.
Yeah. And
I'm not condoning anything Simon does. Like, I'm not saying he's a perfect person. I'm not saying he doesn't have any hand in what happened to them, because he probably does. As a person who wants to make money and as a commodity that he saw One Direction as, he pushed them and they continued to tour. They continued to do all this. And I'm sure that amounted to a lot of stress. And I understand all that. But also, it's a business.
Okay.
I don't know. That's just me.
No, I see your point.
Yeah. And I appreciate everybody that is now unsubscribing from my channel.
I don't think they will.
Yeah. It's just, you know, it's my opinion.
Your opinion.
You are the most exciting pop band in the country today.
One Direction.
Being on
stage is absolutely amazing. I mean, we spend such a short time on there, but we love absolutely every second of it, and you wouldn't change any of it. It's great. This week, the final 12 got to go shopping, and in walking the shop, there were so many people in such a tight
space.
Already
on the final 12, okay.
Yeah, I should have got a lot of shopping done.
Yeah, it seems like it, you know?
Yeah.
I maybe made it to one store. He winked at me! Me! Not you! Me!
Loads of fans, loads of press, people want to take pictures with us.
A couple of months ago, we could just, obviously all of us walk into a shop without any hassle, whereas now, we walk into a shop and get absolutely mocked by screaming girls, which is, well, that's
mind-blowing.
Better than average, innit?
Today during routine, a One Direction came on, and it just didn't sound right.
You think?
Oh no, the tension is building.
Yeah.
Will they perform?
You've chosen the right song, you hear it back. It didn't work. I'm not feeling it. Luckily, they had a second song prepared. I mean, seriously good.
We just got to work hard now and get on with learning this song and get it right.
Changing the song at the very last minute is way too much for most performers.
No drama. Not will they, won't they, they'll just do it. They'll deliver it.
Yeah.
One Direction.
So this is more of a ballad type song, I think, so.
Nobody knows but me. I sometimes cry.
You see the other people like going on with Mary's hair and like, oh, that's how we practiced it.
Is that right? Is that the choreography?
If I could pretend that I'm asleep when my tears start to fall, I peek out from behind these walls. I think nobody knows, nobody knows, and nobody likes,
nobody likes,
nobody likes to lose their inner voice, the one I used to hear before my life made a choice. I think nobody knows, nobody knows.
Baby, hold your secrets safe with me. There's nowhere else in the world that I could ever be. Baby, don't make me feel like you're all alone. Who's gonna be there after the last?
So, for me, that would be a turning point for them. Like, their first two performances were good, but that's where I'd be like, okay, these boys have it.
I wonder what song they were going to use.
Yeah, I don't know. Y'all probably know. Let us know down in the description or the comments.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure they do.
If y'all are still watching after my controversial statement.
Oh, they're better than that.
Yeah, I know, I know.
But
yeah, this is, to me, was their best performance.
Because this was about Zayn and Liam.
Yeah.
And so I wonder who was...
Well, but they were all there in the chorus, which really sounded good.
Well, I know, but, you know, I wonder if they weren't feeling it.
But I liked it. I thought this was their best performance to date.
To date? It really also takes it bothers me because instead of now looking at him like he's lifting them up, he's patting himself.
Well, yeah, you know that.
Yeah, but I never thought that.
There's ego everywhere. But I don't condone or I don't accept anything that he did. Okay. I'm just still defending myself. He has all the responsibility for whatever he did. And I'm going to leave it at that.
That's right. I mean, you would never condone that. But.
Right, yeah. Like, I mean, to me, I signed up for the military knowing full well whatever happens to me, happens to me. I'm not the same person now that I was before, but I don't blame anybody for what happened to me. And I understand it's a little bit of a different thing with the music industry and stuff like that. So I'm not saying comparably they're equal, but that's just my viewpoint on it.
Guys, I mean, you just have to walk out on the stage, everybody's screaming. It's like five Justin Biebers. Brilliant lead vocal from you. This band, you're really getting your act together. I think you are the next big pop band.
See, yeah.
Everybody wants to live that dream with you. And it seems like you're living the dream, you're loving the dream, and you're letting everybody in on that with you. Another great performance. I'm not sure why Pink is a guilty pleasure, though. I'm not sure what you guys listen to for Pink to be a guilty pleasure. Do you know what, guys? Let me just put this out there. You are my guilty pleasure. When you watch the VT and you see all the hysteria you caused when you went out there this week, that's what it should do. That's what boy bands should be about. Whenever the Beatles went anywhere, they caused that level of hysteria, and that's when you know it's a good makings. You're finding your feet now. I look forward to seeing you improve even more in the future.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, all the boy bands, Beatles, Backstreet Boys, NSYNC, New Kids on the Block, we all had that effect.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh.
Well, look, with regards to the song, we chose a song, didn't work. But the good thing about you guys is that there's no bleating on about excuses, I can't do this, I can't do that. It's just a song. You grab hold of it within 24 hours, practice, and I've got to tell you, apart from being a great performance, I thought vocally, you really, really made some huge improvements.
Yeah.
This is an absolute pleasure working with you lot, really.
Way to go, guys.
Also, I would love to hear, like, will you guys link below any comments or anything that they've said after working with Simon about Simon? Because maybe they've come out and said other things that I haven't heard, and I would love to be able to find stuff like that and watch and react to it.
I mean, on the guilty pleasure front, Judge, I think the definition of that's going to be loose all night, so there's pot and kettle with all of you, I think. But going to you guys, how did it feel for you? I mean, Liam doing lead vocal, Louis give you a great big up there. How did it feel?
It's great. We love being here. We really appreciate being in this competition. And every day is just a dream for us at the moment. It's great.
I think we feel like the five luckiest guys on the planet right now. We're loving every minute.
And I imagine more than any other act, you guys going to Topshop and trying to do a bit of shopping would probably be more problematic than any other act here. How was that for you? Because I guess that must have been the first moment, Harry.
It was pretty cool. It was pretty weird. I only got a jumper because I couldn't really move.
You only got a jumper because you couldn't move. And who, honestly, who got asked for the most autographs? Put up your hand.
Harry.
All right. Honest. 0901 6161 106. Number to call to make One Direction very happy. Lines will be opening soon. You can download One Direction's performance. The website has all the details. For now, One Direction.
Thank you.
Yeah, I agree.
Well, the thing is, I haven't been
to you.
I've watched your reactions on these, but I haven't been part of it.
Yeah.
So maybe the detail looking at them from week to week. You know,
you've been on some of them.
Some of them, yes, but not everyone.
Yeah, yeah.
An exclusive of a new Sky TV.
One Direction. Hello. Hello. The girls are screaming for you. You are Cheryl's guilty pleasure. Can we just clarify one thing? Because we get so many emails. Just say yes or no to this question. Girlfriend or not?
No.
No. No.
Yes.
No.
Okay, aww. 4 out of 5 is not bad.
Good job, Louie.
Yes, for good being job. Real.
Bad. Yeah. So, girls, yeah, these boys are for the taking. We're going to go over to Bellamy, who were
Simon's second best.
We love you, Louie. You feel like you're Simon's first best?
No.
Oh, delayed reaction. Okay, well done.
Oh, so they were admitting that One Direction's... Well, yeah. I mean, he said it.
Yeah, yeah, he did. Results.
With all 12 acts tonight, they'll be finding out who stays and who goes.
Oh, I always like this.
Yeah, I just said why. I see them driving around town with the girl I love in my mind. I love the song too. I can tell you, Simon probably hated him.
Oh, yeah.
Probably with a
too
passion.
Too quirky, yeah.
He would be like, you are made for cruise ships.
I'm about to reveal the 10 acts definitely going through to next week's show, and the two who received the fewest votes and will have to sing again in the final showdown. As always, good luck to everyone. in no particular order. The first act returning next week is... Cher.
Yes!
Also through to next week's show, it's... Aiden. The third act safe and definitely returning is...
I knew it. I knew it.
That face said it all.
Yeah. Let's see him give Simon a big hug. Yeah.
Also through next week is Katie. But this is in no particular... One Direction.
Oh, there we go.
I also liked the big black eye.
Yeah,
I like
too.
Him a lot. Yeah. I don't know where,
a lot of personality.
How I got in the competition. But... Yep.
Anyways... Mm-hmm. That was fun. Yeah, so let us know what you thought of it down in the comments. Also, link any kind of interviews that they've said, talked about their relationship with Simon Cowell or anything like that, because I would be interested to know more about it. But anyways, let us know what you thought of it down in the comments. If you liked this video, you can go ahead and give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, you can give it a thumbs down. Not going to hurt me. Or you can give it a thumbs up because it's not going to hurt you. If you're new or you haven't yet, please do subscribe. It does help out the channel. Plus, I'm going to need to replace all the ones that left. And as always, until next time, YouTube, smile like you mean it from the Bushy fam.